first thing you should do, starting work in a house or whatever, in a building, and you suspect there might be asbestos present, is to do a survey. The contractor or the consultant or whoever goes in, they collect the samples of all the material that might be impacted by the work that's going to be done. And they go to a lab, and you get a lab report back, which is the lab analysis report, which will list the samples that were taken, and it'll have some other information where they were taken, what the materials are, whether or not asbestos is present, and what the percentage of asbestos is in there. Now, that report will go to the consultant who is preparing the survey report. The survey report is probably one of the most important reports you can get, which lists the samples that were collected, what the results are, and how that impacts the rest of the house. So if, for example, you go into the house and you take three samples of drywall and it's asbestos, the mud, you make an assumption that it all is. And so you would have to include in the survey report, this is how much material would have to be removed as asbestos. This much drywall, this much flooring, this much ceiling texture, or whatever it has to be, that comes out in that report. And that shows where all the asbestos is and where all the quantities are. The contractor will use that report to generate an estimate and, you know, a scope of the work and be able to give timelines and everything else to the homeowner so that they will know how long it's going to take, how much it's going to cost, and how long they're going to be out of the house, if that's the case. So that report is going to be used by contractors to prepare all the other contract documentation that they have to prepare in order to get the job done. It's all in the planning, and if you misidentify something as non-asbestos that contains asbestos, that cascades down through the whole operation, and a lot of people can be exposed and at risk as a consequence of that. So you really have to know what you're doing. If the work is not done properly before the unprotected people get in there, the list of people potentially exposed is quite long. First off, the homeowner and their family. And then you hire a contractor, say a remediation contractor, to come in to give you an estimate. So they might be exposed. And then you're dealing with the contractor. Well, if the contractor doesn't know that there's asbestos there, then all the contractor's workers could be exposed. When the job is done, if things haven't been done properly, what about the municipal inspectors? Last but definitely not least, the regulators, health and safety officers who go in and do an inspection, are going to be exposed if they don't know what's going on. So if the work isn't done to identify the asbestos and have it removed properly, then you have a cascading reaction with a lot of people who could potentially be exposed. So that's the key. You have to figure out, is asbestos there or not? And everything sort of works from there.